Good evening and welcome to evening prayer for Wednesday, the 29th of March. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. The angels of God guard us through the night and quieten the powers of darkness. The Spirit of God be our guide to lead us to peace and glory. Christ himself bore our sins in his body on the tree. By his wounds we have been healed. Let us confess our sins to God. Almighty God, long-suffering and of great goodness, we confess to you, we confess with our whole heart, our neglect and forgetfulness of your commandments, our wrongdoing, thinking and speaking, the hurts we have done to others, and the good we have left undone. O God, forgive us, for we have sinned against you, and raise us to newness of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Our hymn tonight is James Quinn's hymn, Day is Done, but Love Unfailing.
Done, but love unfailing dwells ever here. Shadows fall, but hope prevailing calms every fear. God, our Maker, non-forsaking, take our hearts of love's unwaking. Watch our sleeping, God awaking, be always near. Dark descends, but light unending shines through our night. You are with us, ever lending new strength to sight. One in love, your truth confessing, one in hope of heaven's blessing, may we see in love's possessing, love's endless light. Eyes will close, but you, unsleeping, watch by our side. Death may come in love's safekeeping, still we abide. God of love, all evil quelling, sin forgiving, fear dispelling, stay with us, our hearts indwelling, this eventide.
And tonight's psalm, selected verses from Psalm 104. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord my God, how excellent is your greatness. You are clothed with majesty and honour, wrapped in light as in a garment. You spread out the heavens like a curtain, and lay the beams of your dwelling place in the waters above. You make the clouds your chariot, and ride on the wings of the wind. You make the winds your messengers, and flames of fire your servants. You laid the foundations of the earth, that it never should move at any time. You make darkness that it may be night, in which all the beasts of the forest creep forth. The lions roar for their prey and seek their food from God. The sun rises and they are gone, to lay themselves down in their dens. People go forth to their work and to their labour until the evening. O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will make music to my God while I have my being. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever. Amen. Continuing with Amy Scott Robinson in her book Images of Grace, A Journey from Darkness to Light at Easter. We share tonight her choice of reading under the title Near and Far Off, Ephesians 2, verses 13 to 22. But now in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace. In his flesh, he has made both groups into one and has broken down the dividing wall, that is, the hostility between us. He has abolished the law with its commandments and ordinances, so that he might create in himself one new humanity in place of the two, thus making peace, and might reconcile both groups to God in one body through the cross, thus putting to death that hostility through it. So he came and proclaimed peace to you who were far off, and to peace and peace to those who were near. For through him both of us have access in one spirit to the Father. So then, you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are citizens with the saints and also members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the cornerstone. In him the whole structure is joined together and grows into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are built together spiritually into a dwelling place for God. Amy writes, Paul is writing to Gentiles in this passage. Just before these verses, he reminds them that they were once strangers to Israel and to the covenants and promises of God, and that as such they had no hope. In Christ Jesus, though, those who once were far off have been brought near. I wonder whether Paul has the parable of the prodigal son in mind when he compares those who were far off with those who were near. If so, he adds another layer of understanding to the parable by imagining the far off as Gentiles rather than the tax collectors and sinners in the crowd Jesus was addressing. It makes Israel into the older son, the one who has always been near the Father, yet never quite reconciled. Paul offers a further ending to the parable. We saw yesterday that the older son was left hanging at the end of the story. Would he decide to go into the party or not? Could he accept reconciliation with his younger brother? Paul states that the reconciliation has now happened through Christ, our peace. There is one humanity in place of the two, and both groups are now equally and together reconciled to God through the cross. This passage is full of pictures and metaphors as Paul explains the new state of peace that exists. First, he says that Christ has broken down a dividing wall representing the hostility between Jews and Gentiles. I have a slight memory of the fall of the Berlin Wall. I was only 7 at the time, but I remember being called to watch the news and told that something momentous was happening. Much later, I visited Berlin and the museum at Checkpoint Charlie, learning about life while the wall was still in place, and the astounding efforts that some had made to cross it, risking their lives and freedom in the process. Very few succeeded. I remember noting the differences that still existed in the infrastructure in what used to be East and West Berlin, and being surprised by the enormous impact of physical structure, representing so much more than its bricks and barbed wire, had made in the history of a city. Paul says that Christ's peace has healed a much deeper and longer division in humanity. Hold on tight, because St. Paul now starts to jump between images like a frog hopping across lily pads. He moves on to talk about citizenship, saying that Gentiles, who used to be foreigners, are now equal citizens in the same kingdom as Israel. In a leap of metaphor, he identifies the kingdom of as God's household, a family together under one roof and with the same head. From there, he makes another metaphorical frog hop to imagining the house itself, a building into which both Gentile and Jewish stones are built on the foundation stones of the apostles and prophets, with Christ as the cornerstone, ordering everything. Another little jump, and the house is a temple, allowing all these people coming together peacefully to create a dwelling place for God on earth. Here, St. Paul lays out something that has been hinted at in many of the passages we have encountered so far in this book. He sees Christ at the centre of the shape of a cross, breaking down a dividing wall to both Jews and Gentiles together into one holy people and reconciling both groups to God. Christ is our peace, both on earth and between heaven and earth. To achieve this, Christ is at the centre of every image. He is the centre of the cross shape, breaking down the wall. He is the king of the one kingdom, the head of the household, the cornerstone of the building which becomes the dwelling place of God. He is the one proclaiming peace to the ones who are far off and peace to the ones who are near. If we're looking for reconciliation, in any direction and at any distance, we need to turn to Christ, because stepping closer to the centre brings us closer in the end to everyone and everything. Amy's question for us to ponder: who do you and I see as far off? And her prayer: Lord, I was far off. Thank you for bringing me into your household, for fitting me into the stones of your temple. May I always have you at the centre of everything I think, say and do, and especially in my dealings with others, remembering that you are our peace. Amen. Guard us, guide us, waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Tonight, the choir of St. Paul's Episcopal Church, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. G. MacFarren's Anglican Chant of the Nunc Dimittis. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Keep us, O Lord, as the apple of your eye. Hide us under the shadow of your wings. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Keep us tonight, Lord, from all sin. Have mercy on us, O Lord, have mercy. Eternal God and Father, under whose mighty and gracious protection all our days are spent, we thank you for the mercies of the day that is now past, for the continuance of so many and great blessings, for any good examples we may have seen, for any good words we may have heard or read, for all holy thoughts and right desires which your Holy Spirit has this day put into our minds. O Lord, grant that these may not be unfruitful in us, but may work in us that for which you sent them. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. Be present, O merciful Lord, and protect us through the silent hours of this night, so that we who are made weary by the changes and chances of this fleeting world may repose upon your eternal changelessness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In our cycle of prayer for this, our East Midlands Synod, we pray tonight for the ministers, elders and members of our churches in Lincolnshire, for the ministry and mission of our places of worship, for those who oversee vacancies, for those tired by their duties and their faithfulness. Breathe upon our people and our churches, we pray, in Lincolnshire, that in partnership with our ecumenical partners, your love and the good news may be shared. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As we recall the words of St. Paul and the whole theme of breaking down walls of hostility, we pray for those places on the world's map marked by hostility and by the effects of hate and violence, for the victims, families of the children in the shooting in the United States, continuing to pray for all caught up in Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We continue to pray for the Reverend Tony Jones, for Vicky Longbone, for the Reverend Louise G and the Reverend Nigel Atkinson. We pray with the Reverend Claire and the Reverend Brian Davison for Susie, their daughter, for the Reverend Derek Hopkins, the Reverend Martin Ferris, the Reverend Stan Crane, the Reverend Michael and Jean Forster, the Reverend Graham and Vera Maskery. And we pray with Moynia and Stella for Father Andy, their parish priest. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray with Tom for Bonnie and for her recovery. And indeed we pray for Tom, giving thanks for his faithful service to this prayer community and to our synod. We pray with Liz for her great-nephew Ryan, daughter Emma and Emma's young son Leon, for Cheryl and for Prince and the family in their ongoing care of her, with Andy for Mike, his dad, and for Liz and Ruth in their ongoing care of him, and with Irene for John. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lighten our darkness, Lord, we pray, and in your mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. God our Father, by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit and the loving obedience of Mary of Nazareth, Virgin and Mother, you gave your Son to be our Redeemer. By the same Spirit, fill us with your grace. Heal the nations and renew your creation, until, with Mary and all your saints, we are crowned forever in the glory of heaven through the merits of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, we will lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. The Lord bless us and watch over us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look kindly on us and give us peace.